It's Championship Fighting Alliance number 3, and it all begins right now.
Coming out of the red corner, fighting out of Tampa, Florida with a 4-0 record, standing 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, Jonathan Turner, 144 and a half. Fighting out of Miami, Florida with a 2-0 record, standing at 5 feet 10 inches tall, out of the blue corner, Joey Judo Rodriguez. .147¾ for Joey.
Here is Jonathan Turner.
Standing 5 feet 10 inches tall. He too weighed in 145 pounds and brings a perfect record, 2 victories and no defeats. Finding out of and representing Miami, Ohio, Miami, Florida, here is Judo Joey Rodriguez.
Now, this bell not brought to you by National Health Transport. Referee in charge of the action, Frank Gentile.
See the age difference. Joey Rodriguez at 21 years old, Turner at 28 years old. Pretty close in height, close in reach. The big difference here is just the age, but they have similar amounts of experience in the cage. John Turner at 4-0 as a pro. Joey Rodriguez at 3-0. Turner is 4-1 as an Ami. Rodriguez 4-0. Rodriguez undefeated both as an amateur and as a professional. Turner with only one loss in 9 fights. Two outstanding featherweights here in Miami. This fight's scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
C-F-A.
Rodriguez is ready to train. Wow.
Misses with that spinning back. This nice judo hip throw. Lands in full mount. This crowd is going absolutely insane.
Joey Rodriguez already flashy, but there goes gentleman John Turner.
Let's not call out Jonathan Turner yet. This is a tough kid. His record speaks for itself.
And John Turner said, once I get someone down on the ground, it is over. Whether by striking or submission, the ground is my world. He lists his stand-up discipline as Muay Thai with some karate flavor, but the ground game is where John Turner likes to be. A ground and pound specialist, as you see Joey Rodriguez composing the guard. Good act of guard for Joey Rodriguez. Oh, he got cut on the forehead. Right above the eye, that could be bad for Rodriguez in terms of vision.
Absolutely, it's right in the center, right above the nose, so yes, it could be. We got Jonathan Turner working that ground and pound there from the guard of Joey Rodriguez. Joey Rodriguez using that cage to reverse, wow. Very nice!
Somehow he got back to his feet. Oh, going for the choke. He's got the full guard. If he tightens that guard up and closes it, looking to finish off John Turner. Very tough to see if he's got the arm underneath the chin of John Turner.
Still working that cage efficiently. Very nice work there off his back there for Joey Rodriguez.
Turner, good job popping out of the choke. Joey keeping Turner in nice and tight. Doesn't want to let him posture up. No more punishment to that forehead. Keep a very close eye on that cut.
Joey Rodriguez again working his full guard. This is Jonathan Turner's second opportunity. He says he can finish this opponent when he brings him down to the ground. Let's see what happens here.
Halfway through the first round. Great action so far. This is our third fight in the featherweight tournament.
And he's going for that arm bar. He's going for that arm bar. Excellent ground game by Joey Rodriguez. And a great reversal by Jonathan Turner. Wow.
Jonathan Turner, no slouch to the ground. 3-time Indiana national wrestling team. The hook and shoot 145 title winner, had to win 3 fights in 1 night. He's also the Indiana Greco-Roman state champion. This guy is a stud on the ground.
Stand him up!
Graduated at the top of his class in both high school and college. Has a bachelor's degree in biology. So he's smart physically and smart mentally as well.
Nice reversal. And back up to their feet.
Good action.
Nice straight right by Joey Rodriguez brings his opponent down to the camera. But I'll tell you, Jay, Jonathan Turner's got some amazing wrestling.
Turner was very smart there to shoot the double. He was down low, he shot, and that killed all the momentum of Joey. There's a good look at the cut. Nice job, guys. So far, knock on wood, no blood draining into the either eye socket of the real deal. Joey calling for the rest of the crowd to join in with his corner. His corner was yelling to Frank Gentile to stand him up, and Joey looked over his corner and said, yeah, come on, stand him up.
Stand us up, there's not much going on here.
Joey wants a slugfest. He's got that freestyle flow to him. Controlled violence, he calls it. I asked him what impact the sport had on him. He said, it made me a stranger person. Good job of avoiding the ground and pound.
Very nice work by both these athletes.
Good first round. Tough round to score.
Tough round to score, Jake.
I would have to probably give it to Turner because he had all the takedowns and he damaged Joey.
Absolutely. I think that all the reversals, all the takedowns, he dominated the ground game over Joey, even though Joey's the more, you know, aggressive fighter. Landing more of the shots in the stand-up, I would definitely have to give that round to Jonathan Turner.
Joey had some flash, and the judges love it. He had some great connections. And, you know, clearly the very dramatic fighter of the two is Joey, the real deal Rodriguez. However, John Turner did the damage, controlled where the fight went, and was able to get the takedowns when he needed them.
I agree.
Here's some of that ground and pound, and then there's the end. Good blood between the fighters. Nice shot. Just had a nice look at the cut. No problem with the cut so far. Joey has dodged a bullet. Superman punch to open the second round. He connects with it. And then the sprawl.
Great start of round two here for Joey Rodriguez. Joey Rodriguez attempts a judo throw and Jonathan Turner uses that to his advantage and gives him a nice little wrestling takedown there.
Showed a lot of power because all that momentum, he stopped it and made it go the other way. Good upper body strength from the gentleman, John Turner. John Turner, the scholar, guitar player, holds the degree in biology, graduating top of his class and not just high school, but college as well. And of course, this biggest night in his MMA career, winning three fights in one night to win the title.
Those are amazing accomplishments. And that's a pedigree of someone that really wouldn't actually choose fighting as a career, huh, Jay?
Fights out of Gracie, Tampa, under the tutelage of Rob Kahn and Joe Wissman. Rob Kahn, one of the first Americans to get a black belt from Hoist Gracie. Also fights under Joe Brooks, Anthony Castellucci, Dennis Alzagari. Rob Kahn holds one of the best, if not the best schools in Central Florida. He's put 9 or 10 fighters in the Ultimate Fighter.
Wow. Right now, Jonathan Turner trying to pass Joey Rodriguez's guard. Joey Rodriguez working on that guillotine choke.
Great hips there by Joey Rodriguez. Now he's going to walk the cage, get back to his feet, but great single leg here by John Turner. Wrestling is such a good sport, such a, I mean, it's not even fair to call it one of the compliments. It's so integral. It's such a pillar of this sport.
Absolutely. It's such an important factor too, Jay, because when you have a wrestler, his job is to manipulate and control his opponent's weight and body down on the canvas. You teach him some really good jiu-jitsu and you got a phenom on your hands. Referee stands him back up.
2.5 minutes to go in the second round.
And this is Joey's world. This is where he wants to be.
Joey Rodriguez knows he has to stuff the takedown.
Beautiful leg kick by Joey Rodriguez, buckles his opponent's leg. Beautiful shoot by Jonathan Turner. Wow. Back into the full guard of Joey Rodriguez.
That was an absolutely nasty leg kick that buckled Turner's leg in a way the leg's not supposed to buckle. It buckled in. And Turner didn't show it, but I'm guessing that hurt. But Joey finds himself in the predicament he has found himself in for half of this fight. So tough to stuff the takedown of such a high quality wrestler.
It's nice to see Jonathan Turner come out with an amazing shoot like that after taking such a difficult leg shot. Crowd chanting Joey Rodriguez's name right now, still in the full guard.
Look for something off your back, bro, come on.
He's gotta get more active in the guard, or he could tie up John. Frank Gentile has shown that he will stand up the fighters, and he just indeed warned Turner to get more active.
Turner trying to press up Joey Rodriguez against the cage, make sure he doesn't give him much room to escape. Start raining down his ground and pound.
Rodriguez lobbying Gentile, saying this guy's not doing anything to me.
He's got to be careful he doesn't give up an arm here. Joey Rodriguez with a high guard.
10 seconds to go in the second round. And round number two in the record books. Very similar to round number one.
Very similar, and I would have to go again and agree with you on round number one also. I would give this second round to Jonathan Turner as well, just based on his wrestling, takedowns, and able to control Joey's body on the ground for such an amount of time during this round.
A flashy Joey Turner, not able to stop the takedowns of gentleman John Turner. When we come back, it's the third and final round. Trying to compose the triangle.
Working
They're
that
very
rubber
slippery,
guard.
Though.
Very slippery to try to get this. He's got his, he definitely has his leg over. He's got a high guard.
Work for it, keep working for it.
He can't get that triangle. He might transition it into an arm bar, depending on what Jonathan Turner does right now. If he tries to posture up, he's got to be careful he doesn't give up an arm.
Very good flexibility being demonstrated by the real deal. Nice high rubber guard, keeping Turner from doing anything from this position.
Stand him up, boy, stand him up.
And Turner, good job of getting that arm out.
Oh, he wanted that arm bar. He ate the left elbow for the attempt. Joey Rodriguez looking to his corner from his position. Good composition, good composure there by the 21-year-old. Rodriguez trying to protect that undefeated record. He does not want the blemish on the pro record of 3-0. Turner's protecting an undefeated record as well.
Absolutely. He's going to have to work really hard here, Jay, to get himself out of this position, because it's all Jonathan Turner right now. Trying to grab that arm. That cage is obstructing him from extending. He's going to have to roll under to his stomach if he can. He's got great flexibility.
Trying to extend, trying to stretch out. Conversely, John Turner trying to make himself real heavy, bunch up, pile up on top of Rodriguez. You can see Joey trying to get that left leg over to the face, turn. Like you say, he's got to spin off the cage. Gives up on the arm bar. And now Turner looked like he might be going for the choke. Yep.
Turner's got a very tight guillotine in here. He's trying to get one arm in. And very nice sweep by Joey Rodriguez using that same guillotine in order to sweep him. Turner's not going to be able to get it from this position. He's got to be at least in half guard. Joey pops his head out. Wow. And it is all Joey Rodriguez right now, raining down punches for this ground and pound. Got to be careful he doesn't get ankle locked here.
He's going for the ankle. I think the ankle's free. And now he's got dominant position on Turner.
Will he get this referee to stop the match? This crowd is going crazy.
Oh, he's got mount full. He's got half mount.
Wow.
Let the hands go. Oh, what a scramble. Oh, CFA action here in Miami, Florida. Joey Rodriguez in the north-south.
Joey, sit up and turn. Sit up and turn. Pound him.
Great positioning here for Rodriguez, but he's trying to figure out what to do. He's got a minute to go in the fight to try to capitalize on this position. What does Turner have to do?
As Joey spanks him, we got a Randy Couture, Tito Ortiz flashback.
We got a stalemate here. Rodriguez very relaxed, but he's got less than a minute here to put it together.
40 seconds.
And he gets to stand up. 25 seconds to try to put it on Turner.
I think that's what Joey Rodriguez wants, back up on his feet. Fight's over. The crowd is so loud, Jay. Fight's over, and they still got the armbar. They can't even hear the bell ring. This is an amazing fight.
Turner could not hear the noise. And both corners going over to each fighter to lift them up, possibly in the fight of the night. Wow.
God, Jay, we still got a lot of amazing action headed up. But if they want to win fight of the night, they're going to have to actually, they got some big shoes to fill with this particular fight. Incredible matchup. between Joey Rodriguez and Jonathan Turner. Wow, I would not want to be the judges for this fight. Unofficially, who do you got, Jay, on this one?
On my unofficial scorecard, I got Turner winning rounds 1 and 2, 10-9, 10-9. I got Rodriguez winning the third round, 10-9. Razor thin. This could go either way. All right, we come back. It's the decision. Don't touch that dial.
Unofficially, are we going to have the first split decision of the evening? Wow, what a fight. Fight of the night so far. Fight of the night so far. So far. Olvídate que this is fight of the night so far. Wow. Wow, that's a crazy fight, man. These guys work so hard that they should give them a split. It's been. Porque si, tuvo lo takedown and he brought him down, pero no hizo mucho. Exactly, you know what I mean? It's like. Look at this, look. And it's a fight, and it's a pig.
That's good.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the scorecards. One more time, Abby, let's hear it for these two young warriors inside the cage. Here are the judges' totals. Judge Hector Gomez scores at 29-28, Rodriguez. Judge Rich Corrine has it 29-28 for Turner. And Judge Eliseo Rodriguez scores the bout 30-27 for your winner by split decision and advancing to the quarterfinals or to the semifinals, Miami's own Judo Joey Rodriguez.
Over Jonathan Turner.
All right. Yeah, go ahead. Good. Quickly. It takes two to put on a show like that, and I know that's why you went over to give him love. Yeah. John Turner, you guys. It takes two. I'll talk with John in a second. He deserves it. Joey Rodriguez, come on over here. John, don't go anywhere. Joey Rodriguez, an early bid for fight of the night. Got a lot of great fights coming up. Yeah.
Give me that fucking fight of the night, man. That was amazing adversity, dude.
We still got the lightweight tourney, co-main and main event coming up. So we got a lot of good fights coming up, but an early bid for sure, Joey. Walk us through some of the action there. Clearly, this guy's a wrestling stud. I mean, he holds like 9 titles in wrestling. He's a wrestling monster. You had to game for that. How did your corner game that? How did you handicap that wrestling skill he had?
Dude, I knew he was an awesome wrestler. I tried to work some jiu-jitsu sweeps. I worked half the time, not half. But you know, it was an awesome fucking fight. And clap it up for Turner, man. Awesome fucking fighter. Luckily at the end, I could pound him out a little bit. I thought I was rocking him, obviously I was. But hey, dude's tough as nails, he didn't go out, his lights never went out. I take my hat off to him, but I fought all the way through the end and I got that victory.
Stay right here, Joey. John Turner, come over here for a second. Don't go anywhere, Joey. John Turner, it takes two to tango, it takes two to make a maybe fight of the night. You had wrestling stud. You knew you had to get the takedowns. Did you feel that you got the takedowns you needed to win this? What's your thought on it?
I did, but he kicked me in my leg, in my knee early in the fight, like both of my legs, so my knees, they feel like they want to just buckle out from underneath me. So he hit me with a real good kick early on, so I knew since he had me hurt, I had to go back to my base. I'd been working striking a lot, but you know, my leg hurts really bad, so I figured I'd go to the ground and go where, you know, my strength is, so.
Well, John Turner, I think that you made a good showing for yourself here tonight, and I think that the executives, the powers that be here at CFA are taking note of that. When you have a fight like that, the odds are you're coming back. You don't advance in the tourney, but I think you have a very good shot of coming back to Miami.
Thank you, man. Good luck to you. Awesome fight, man. Hopefully we'll get fight of the night. And hell, maybe we might even train together or something in the future. So thanks a lot, Miami. It was great to come here and great to fight. I appreciate it. I know he's a hometown guy, but thanks a lot, guys.
Class act, John Turner, class act. Joey Rodriguez, you do advance to the tournament. Come over here, my friend. You do advance to the tournament. Did you have a chance to watch any of the other 45 fights? Especially Jordan Parsons looked very, very tough out there. Had a very nasty beatdown. He actually had kind of a mean, gritty style where he really punished his opponent. Did you have a chance to see Jordan Parsons fight? And if so, what do you think of him?
Not at all. I mean, if me and him are both advancing, it'll be an honor to fight him. I'm not scared of anybody, not perform with whoever. That's all I gotta say. I wanna eat some water, man.
All I could say is that's a tasty fight. Jordan Parsons and Joey Rodriguez. One more time for your neighbor, Miami's own Joey Rodriguez, you guys.
He does a lot of wushu, he does a lot of mental preparation, a lot of meditation.
This ought to be interesting to see this stand-up discipline. Nikolai Curry, more traditional stand-up boxing.
After seeing these guys in the weigh-ins yesterday, Jay, you can tell they put on a little bit of weight. Nikolai looks real, real heavy, looks big for a 170-pounder from yesterday's weigh-ins.
Nikolai Curry, 6'2". Jose Casares is 6'2 as well. Good height for welterweight. Slowly stalking Nikolai is Jose Casares, just 24 years old.
Feeling out process here in this first round.
Kung Fu never really made its way too strongly into the stand-up discipline of the mixed martial artist, but Jose Casares looking to change that. He is undefeated.
Both fighters very patient. Casares brings his opponent down to the ground. Very nice. Now working diligently to pass. Scramble on the ground. He's got a high. He's going for a triangle choke. He's got it sunk in. Casares in a lot of trouble here right now. The fact that he's in the seated position right now, Jay, is the only thing saving him right now from getting that neck crank. If he inverts it into an arm bar here, it's another thing he might do. He needs to posture up here.
See,
Casares should be using his left hand right now to break that leg grip that he's got over him with a triangle and holding on. Is he going to go for an inverted triangle, I think? Very nice.
Squeezing tight. He's giving it all he has right here. And there you can see Nikolai Curry defending.
If he were to put his right hand under his crotch and actually his left hand and grab the body from there, which it looks like he's doing now, very nice. He's going to sink it in.
Looking to tighten it up around the armor, Nikolai Curry. The American top team protege, 4-2 as a pro.
Right now, the fact that Nikolai's got that right arm pushing off of his left leg is what's saving him from being choked out.
Nikolai Curry looking to referee Troy Wall. He's letting him know he's coherent, everything's fine, no panic. And now right now, Troy Wall is telling both fighters to improve their position, but especially Jose. Because Jose does not want the stand-up right now.
I think the more the Nikolai comes down to his stomach, it's going to make it a little easier for him to sink it in. He should actually posture up the way he was before. Caceres raining down now. Caceres has some elbows.
Less than 2 minutes to go in the opener. A very interesting first round, to say the least.
Very.
Interesting tangle. Nikolai looking like it might be tightening up around him a little bit. His face is getting more red. Seeing more veins coming out of his head, as you can see. Jose really starting to clamp down.
He's clamping down, Jay, and what he's doing, he's pushing off with that right hand. He's using so much energy pushing off with his right hand to make sure that Caceres does not sink in this move any tighter, that it's really tiring him out. You're absolutely right. He's getting red. He's getting winded.
Caceres really trying to clamp down, get the vice going, use all that leverage.
He's going for a Kimura here. He's going for a Kimura, he's got that arm.
He's pulling, oh, Nikolai is in all kinds of trouble. His face is turning purple, trying to release the pressure.
There he goes, he's trying to roll to his stomach. Caceres is in order to be able to move and actually flatten his hips out a little, but he's going for that Kimura in the back. Great move, great move by Nikolai, great move.
Nikolai Curry is out of trouble.
One hook in, takes the back of Caceres, now he's got both hooks in.
And you can see Caceres with the wrist control, very tough to choke out your opponent with just one hand. Now 10 seconds to go in the opening round as Nikolai's trying to finish him from this dominant position. It's going to be very, very tough, though, in 5 seconds. Good defense by Caceres. Oh, they're going for the armbar. 5 seconds to go.
He taps. Oh, my God.
2 seconds.
2 seconds on the clock, and Caceres taps out.
Wow. Tapping out. Nikolai Curry taps out Jose Caceres with just 2 seconds to go in the round.
Wow. Impressive.
So Nikolai Curry moving to 5-2 as a pro out of American Top Team, Coconut Creek, right here in Florida. The 31-year-old has got to be happy with that performance. Fought off that inverted triangle forever, turned it around, and got the armbar with just seconds to go. There it is.
Yes, Jay, and I'll tell you, all he had to do was keep that right leg where it was for a couple more seconds, and he would not have let Nikolai extend that arm into the armbar. Wow, 2 seconds left. Great victory for Nikolai Curry.
Maybe we'll take another look at it. You talk us through. I'm going to hop up into the cage and talk to the armor. Close it yet. Thanks.
And here we have the official decision.
4 minutes, 57 seconds, round number one, submission by armbar for your winner out of Miami, Florida, Nikolai the Armor Curry!
A great shot right up there, Nikolai. You take a look at that as we talk through this. You fought off that inverted triangle forever. Your face started turning all kinds of shades of purple, and you had the veins coming out of your head, but you fought it off like the true warrior you are, and here it is right here at the last second, with literally seconds to go on the clock in the opener. You tapped him out. You've got to be happy with your performance tonight.
I'm very happy. I'm very surprised with my opponent. He's so strong for such a skinny guy, you know. Big hand for him, very good round. I'm doing that forever, you know. I don't know how he escaped from that first triangle and caught me in a triangle, you know. I was so surprised. But that's a sport, you know. Anything can happen.
It was a great tangle and some incredible positions back and forth. He's an undefeated fighter. This is a good notch in your belt. You moved to 5-2. What can we look forward to in your future?
I think I train with the best, you know. American top team, if not the best team in the world, one of the best. You know, I have to really have high plans, you know, to get to the UFC or whatever show is out there. But I would like to congratulate CFA for a wonderful show, for taking care of the fighters the way they should do, you know, so proud of them. Good job. Just one more thing, I'd like to thank my team, American Top Team, Jesus Christ for everything, my wife, my good friend Bob and Gary Morency, and Barry's Vitamins and Herbs for keeping me healthy. Thank you so much.
All right, nicely done. One more time for the armor. Moving to 5-2, Nikolai Curry, you guys.